Have you ever wondered who is visiting my website? Well, there's a tool in HubSpot that can tell you just that.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
If you're looking for people that have visited your website, you can actually find out those domains specifically in HubSpot using a tool called Prospects in the Analytics section. So let's dive in and actually show you where to look for that information and how you can sift and sort that to put it to use in your marketing. So when you're here on this home screen, we're gonna dive into the reports section, and from reports, you're gonna click on analytics tools. Now, analytics tools is gonna give you a whole bunch of things here. As you scroll below the fold, you have this tool called prospects. So when I click on this, I'm actually gonna open up the window that is already open here to show you. I've got this filtered for you to look at. It's a little bit more helpful when we filter the data. So this is that prospects tool. This is gonna tell me all of the domains that are hitting my website or my domain, and it's gonna give me some high level information about those companies. So for instance, I've got, I'm on page two, let's go back to page one. I've got internet service provider is equal to false. So I do wanna set up a filter here so that I filter out, you know, if it's Verizon or if it happens to be Quest or Spectrum. I also wanna filter out that their industry is telecommunications. That's also gonna most likely be an internet provider. So once I filter those out, then I've got these different companies here. And if I click on this preview button, I can preview more information about that company. So in this case, there is some things you wanna probably think about for the domains that are hitting your website. In this case, we have a lot of resources on our website about how to build a marketing plan and how to conduct marketing research. And there's a good chance we are close to this university that there are students that are looking for this information and they're ending up on our website and getting that information. If I wanted to go a little bit further, if I am using this in the way that HubSpot designed it and I'm actually prospecting companies that were interested in my content, I can click on view in LinkedIn, and then if I proceed to LinkedIn to look at that record, I click on the company, I click on the employees who work there, that's a sales discovery way for me to find people maybe that are connected one degree away that I might need an intro to. Maybe I've seen something on their LinkedIn marketing that I can help with. So that's, for a marketing company, that makes sense. For you, it might just be, again, finding people that you know that are connected to someone who of that company hit your website. Now, just because someone visited your website doesn't mean they may be qualified to buy, or they might even be qualified in your services at all. So use this along with a lot of other different ways to prospect in order to get an accurate picture on who you're going after. If you wanted to add more fields inside of this section over here, this is basically the display of all that data. I'm gonna pull down on actions, click edit columns, and then I can add in, again, any of these different pieces of information. I can even add in source data. Because if I do this, then on source, I've got direct traffic, organic. This is, again, a good indicator of the types of ways people are getting into your website. So if I wanted to create, let's say, an account-based marketing list using this information, I can actually add these companies to HubSpot, and then I just do it easily using this plus button. So I add this company here, and I've got Colo Crossing now in my HubSpot. I might want to go in and add some more information in there, add them to a relevant list. There's a lot more work you need to do beyond this, but this report should give you a little bit of perspective on who is visiting your website. And again, it's right inside the HubSpot tool that you're already using. So for more tips, tricks, and how-tos, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and we'll come at you next week with another video. Drop a comment below about any questions or maybe a topic you want to see in a future video. We'll see you next week.